Welcome to O'Brothers RC. In this video, we're going to take a look at this recent 1/24 scale Jeep. So let's get it out of the box and see what it's all about. Looks like you got a charger, a manual, and it looks like one of the mirrors is already broken off. Got an extra battery on the top here, which is cool. It's a 380 lithium ion. Inside the clamshell, you've got this controller, some batteries for the controller, and the truck itself. So my first impression is that this thing looks really cool. The body is actually really cool. This body actually looks a lot better than the SCX24 Jeep. The controller looks pretty nice as well. It's got a foam wheel. It's got dual rate steering and throttle. It's got a push button function for the lights as well. It feels good and it doesn't look too bad and it's not too big. The Jeep itself looks really nice. It does, it looks great. I really like it. But that's where the good things about this Jeep end. So the first thing that I don't like about this truck is the body clips here. It's kind of cool because, you know, you don't have any body clips sticking through the top, which is great. But these are extremely hard to get to. So these are not very convenient and kind of hard to get off. But that's not a deal killer. It's got a nice light setup. Headlights, blinkers on the front, and taillights on the back. And like I said, other than the mirror that fell off, this is a pretty sweet body. Really very cool. It's got quite a bit of weight to the back because of this tire here. But other than that, it's very nice. Underneath the body, it's set up quite similar to an SCX24. You have the ESC in the front, the transmission and motor here in the center of the chassis, and the battery right behind that. The four link looks very similar to the SCX24. The drive lines and everything are very similar. The tires and wheels are just about the same as the SCX24, with one big and very important difference. These are like a hard rubber. They are not soft, they are not flexible, and they're not gonna function well. The SCX24's tires are much softer and much stickier. The axles and differentials are very similar to the SCX24. Shocks are very similar as well. The springs are kind of stiff, so you're not going to get a ton of travel out of these shocks. The chassis is flat plate. It's not a C-channel. One thing that I noticed right away was the steering angle. This is your max steering angle on this recent truck. And this is your max steering angle on the SCX24. And you can see that there is a big difference. This thing is not going to have a good turning radius. It's going to be really poor, actually. Underneath, they look very, very similar. The four link, the drive lines, the transmission brace or skid plate is very much the same. They are very, very similar. I'm guessing that all the parts that work on an SCX24 would actually work on this thing as well. But most importantly, we want to check out the ESC and see how this thing crawls. The ESC and battery are definitely different from the SCX24. And honestly, I don't have much hope for this ESC. The power button's right here on the side. Just give it a little push and she's powered on. Or not. Okay, so right off, I push the power button and the ESC is on and the controller is on, but I've got nothing. Let's try it again. So oddly enough, when I turned the ESC on first and the controller on second, which is backwards, it worked. Weird. But yeah, look at the steering angle here. It's absolutely terrible. The tires move maybe a quarter of an inch each way. It's ridiculous. Like, that's horrible. I do like that it has lights on the front and on the back. Turn signals I could do without. So I'm gonna set up a couple rocks here on the bench and let's give this thing a short little crawl before we take it outside. Let's see how the ESC functions and if it can crawl over these tiny obstacles here. So it's very jumpy and you know, there's almost no slow crawl function. You can get it to drive slowly if it's not crawling over any obstacles and it's got sort of a hiccup in its drive line somewhere. So it's not running very smooth at all. There's almost no slow control whatsoever. And yeah, the turning radius sucks. It's also got some major driveline issue or something. I mean, look at it chatter. That is not good. I'm not sure why, but it seems like it's got a hazard light function as well, but there's no way to turn it off. It just kind of does it on its own. So I got to tell you, even for $85, I'm pretty disappointed in this little truck. I really don't like when manufacturers put junk like this out. They clearly don't care about the customer with this one. All you'd have to do is run this thing around your factory to find out that it's kind of a piece of crap. The mirror fell off right out of the box. It chatters like a bunch of old ladies on Sunday morning. The body clip systems suck. They're hard to get to and they're gonna hang up on the rocks, no doubt about it. You could probably put some smaller ones on here, but then they'd be even harder to get to. And most importantly of all, the ESC, it's just not good. You can bump your way over an obstacle, but there's absolutely no smooth, slow crawl whatsoever. The turning radius is just abysmal. That means bad. So I've seen some other reviews on this truck and guys are saying that, oh, it's a good truck, I can go buy one. Well, let me tell you, you don't want to buy this thing. Even for 85 bucks, you're wasting your money. The only thing that you're going to want to use from this truck would be the body, which is pretty cool. I could glue the mirror back on and it would be a pretty cool body. But I've got SCX 24 Jeeps, so I'm telling you right now, don't waste your money on this thing. I'm going to go ahead and put the link in the description in case you don't want to believe me and you want to go buy one yourself. And that's not a bad thing because with Amazon's return policy, you can send this thing back with no problem. So if you want to find out for yourself, go ahead and order one and then you can just send it back when you get it because you're going to send it back. It's a POS. If you've seen any other reviews that are telling you anything other than this is a POS and to not waste your money, they're lying and they're probably making money on the link that they've got in their description. And the money is more important to them than telling the truth. And that sucks. So because this thing couldn't even roll over a couple rocks on my bench here without trouble, I'm not even gonna take it outside. It's not worth wasting my time. So in summary, the only thing that I like about this truck is the body and the fact that I bought it from Amazon and I can just send it back. But if you wanna waste your money and your time, I'm gonna put the link to this truck in the description. It's 85 bucks. Even at 85 bucks, it's not worth it because the only thing I would use from this truck would be the body. And I'm not spending 85 bucks for a 1/24 scale body. But like I said, Amazon's got a killer return policy. So if you want to check this truck out for yourself, you can get one and then just send it back after you find out how much of a POS it is. I'm sorry if I didn't tell you what you wanted to hear. But I'm always going to tell it like it is here at O Brothers RC. If you like cool custom builds, hit that subscribe button and tap the bell. And when you think, I want to hear a truthful review about the RC car I'm going to buy, think Go Brothers RC. Thanks for watching.